What's up guys, welcome to a new My Team Career Mode episode. Today we're gonna go to Singapore, a track with lots of twists and turns. So let's see how our car will fare around there.
I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We'll need to tell the team what to redevelop via the R&D screen.
We've got a failed R&D upgrade once again. It's starting to become a common occurrence. But luckily, it's an engine upgrade and not the chassis upgrade, because we're already doing better than any other team in terms of engine performance. Our chassis, though, it's still quite poor. In terms of chassis performance, we're only just ahead of the Haas and on par with Williams, so there's big gains to be made there. But that's enough about the upgrades, let's go to the race weekend. If we're looking at the weather, it's gonna be raining during qualifying, but during the race it's gonna be dry. So I'm gonna go for a dry car setup and hope for the best during quali. Here we go. That's P8 in quali. I never expected to be starting in the top 10 with this car in Singapore. It's gonna be an interesting race. Let's see if we can score some points.
Against the spectacular backdrop of the Singapore skyline, Formula One returns once again to do battle in what tends to become something of an endurance race, with the notorious sauna-like temperatures in the cockpit making for an extremely physically challenging Grand Prix. The Marina Bay Street Circuit then has 23 corners, 13 to the left and 10 to the right, taking us a total of 3.1 miles around the landmarks of downtown Singapore. An average lap speed around here, just 107 miles per hour. Alongside me once again for coverage of today's race, it's none other than the great Anthony Davidson. Why don't we discuss McLaren? What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within that team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do, and that's definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Leclerc, Carlos Sainz, and Perez, Norris, Jackson, Ricciardo, and Pierre Gasly, Fernando Alonso, Vettel, Yuki Tsunoda, and Ocon, Massa, Stroll, Kimi Raikkonen, and George Russell, Giovinazzi, Mick Schumacher, Latifi, and Nikita Mazepin. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Thank you. right, let's get the car up to temperature on this lap. We're learning the gears, so go through them all if you can. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch. We're sat in sixth.
Norris is ahead of you.
Less than a second separate you. They're on fresh softs.
Leclerc is behind you.
The gap to the car behind is 1.8 seconds. They're on fresh hards. Our gap to first place is 3.6 seconds. Your pit window opens in 9 laps time. 30 laps till the end now. DRS is now available. Norris ahead. The gap is less than a second. They're on old softs. Their tyres are 3 laps old. We think they've got 2 stops remaining. The time last lap was a 1 minute 41.6. You're gaining by 1/10 a lap. We're leading our teammate by 11.3 seconds.
have P5?
P5. Perez is ahead of you.
Okay.
Gap ahead is 1.2 seconds. They're on old mediums.
Norris is behind you.
They're on old softs. The gap to the leader is 5.7 seconds. Six laps until your pit window is open. 27 laps to go. Front is 1.8 seconds. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 5 laps old. We think they've got 2 stops remaining. The time last lap was a 1:42.0. You're falling back by 1/10 a lap. Okay, clear. Gap to the car ahead is 2.1 seconds. Leclerc behind. The gap behind us is 6.1 seconds. They're on fresh hards. Their tyres are 6 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1 minute 42.8. P5, you're in P5. Perez is ahead of you. Gap to car in front is 2.8 seconds. They're on old mediums. Leclerc is behind you. Okay, the gap behind is 6.1 seconds. They're on old hards. The distance to the leader is 9.2 seconds. Pit window will open in 3 laps time. Pit window opens in 3 laps. 24 laps to go. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the hards. Ahead. Okay, gap ahead is 2.7 seconds. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 9 laps old. We think they've got 2 stops remaining. The time last lap was a 1:42.6. We're gaining by around 0.2 per lap. Gap to the car in front is 3.0 seconds. In this lap, push now. 13. You are currently in P13.
Russell is ahead of you.
Less than a second separate you. They're on old mediums.
Schumacher is behind you.
Our gap behind is 3.5 seconds. They're on old mediums. Okay, gap to leader, 39.0 seconds. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. You have 20 laps till the end. Is ahead of you. The gap to the car ahead is 4.6 seconds. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 12 laps old. We think they've got two stops remaining. The time last lap was a 1 minute 44.4. In the pits, Felipe in the pits. Perez is ahead of you. Gap to car in front is 24.2 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. We think they've got one more stop. Gap ahead is 4.9 seconds. Signs behind. The gap to the car behind is 5.4 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are one lap old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1:40.1.
catching the car ahead, but remember, we need to get to the end of the race on these tyres. Some information on Vettel. They have an issue with their car. They're going to be slow. Ricardo is ahead of you. Our gap to the car in front is 6.1 seconds. They're on old hards. Their tyres are 15 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1 minute 43.3. You're gaining by 8 tenths. 8 tenths. The gap to the car ahead is 6.1 seconds. Seconds to the next car, 6 seconds. Behind is 23.6 seconds. You have P7, 7th place. Ricardo ahead. Gap to car in front is 5.1 seconds. They're on old hards. Sainz is behind you. The gap is less than a second. They're on old mediums. Our gap to first place is 24.6 seconds. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. 14 laps to go. Incident which has resulted in lots of loose debris on the track. The safety car is being deployed. Right, come in at the end of this lap.
complete. Go now. Safety car is in this lap. Safety car in this lap. Let's make sure those tyres are up to temperature, and remember, there is no overtaking until the timing line. Stay in position until the green flags. Green flag. Ninth position, Stroll is ahead of you. Less than a second separate you. They're on old mediums. Ocon behind, they're on old mediums. The gap to the leader is 4.0 seconds. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. There are 10 laps to go. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Okay, gap ahead is 1.7 seconds. Stewards have now enabled DRS. DRS is now online. Yellow flag.
some information on Verstappen. It looks like the problem is terminal. They're retiring the car. Okay, clear. P7 now. P7. Vettel ahead. The gap is less than a second. They're on old mediums. Ocon is behind you. The gap behind us is 2.4 seconds. They're on old mediums. The distance to the leader is 8.2 seconds. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. 8 laps to go. P5, P5. Ricardo is ahead of you. Our gap to the car in front is 1.8 seconds. They're on old mediums. Vettel behind, they're on old mediums. Okay, gap to leader, 7.0 seconds. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. 7 laps to go. The gap to the car ahead is 3.4 seconds. Felipe is coming in for his stop. Fourth position, you're in fourth position. Ricardo ahead, gap to car in front is 4.0 seconds. They're on old mediums. Gasly is behind you. Okay, the gap behind is 2.3 seconds. They're on old mediums. Our gap to first place is 8.8 seconds. Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. 6 laps to go. Gasly behind. Our gap behind is 2.3 seconds. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 6 laps old. The time last lap was a 1:42.4. Okay, gap ahead is 5.7 seconds.
Mind that front wing. It'll need replacing if it takes too much damage. No issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Gasly is behind you. Less than a second separate you. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 8 laps old. The time last lap was a 1 minute 42.8. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Safety car is out. We need you to reduce your pace. It looks like there's a high amount of debris on the track. Some information on Gasly. They've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring. There's 4 laps of fuel remaining. Okay, let's get ready to go racing again. The safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember, there is no overtaking until the green flags. Safety car in this lap. Green flag. We're in P4. Ricardo is ahead of you. The gap is less than a second. They're on old mediums.
Russell is behind you.
Less than a second separate you. They're on old hards. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. 2 laps left. Next time by will be your final lap. just 3 laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. You're pulling out a second lap on the car behind. Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home.
They've endured the harsh conditions here in Singapore to pull off a spectacular victory. And talk to me, what do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
Without a doubt, the safety car changed everything today. The key to their success was keeping calm and reacting to the situation quickly. We've seen teams in the past throw away wins because they were too hesitant, but here they were decisive and that's allowed them to take the advantage.
Ferrari are at it again, an excellent performance at today's Grand Prix, and they're certainly a team that know what they're doing out there. Let's see how the driver standings have changed. It's a great result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Well, there's no question in my mind, it has to go to George Russell. What a performance. He's got every right to be proud of what he accomplished out there today.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. It was a tough race for our championship leaders, who lose ground at the top of the table. Another team that excelled today was Williams, who make further progress up the table. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.